Hey guys.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey Richard.
Hello, hello. How are you?
Hello, hello. How are you? How are you feeling?
I'm doing great. I am doing absolutely fabulous. I guess I'm amazing a lot of people at how quickly I bounced back.
Good.
Can't believe it's only been 3 weeks.
Bounced back.
Bounced back from gallbladder surgery.
Oh.
They took it. They didn't replace it with nothing. I've never heard of a gallbladder transplant.
Hey, maybe it's sitting next to mine somewhere.
Yeah, mine's got a golf ball-sized gallstone in it, too.
Ooh. Ooh. I didn't ask. I was
just get it out, you said.
Hey, Marie, how are you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. I'm just getting a little workout, you know. A lot to think about, a lot to go around, but I'm doing well.
Good.
How about you?
Yeah.
Good.
Looking forward to it. I'll be happy when this art show is over.
Oh, yeah. I had one last weekend, so this is 2 weekends in a row. But
you've been amazing.
Oh, thank you. I've got 8 pictures to wire today, and then I'll be done. I'll be ready. I left all my own stuff to the last minute.
Yeah. Here's our new sign, the big guy.
Ooh, nice.
Oh, wow. That's the one from the library?
Yeah, that'll be hanging in the community room.
Okay, great.
I thought it'd be great for the radio, huh?
Yeah, Michael said he was going to try to listen on the radio. So.
I'm on for right now.
Oh, are you?
It's news right now.
Oh, it's still the news? Oh, okay.
I'm going to record it.
Yeah, it is.
I am going to record it. Oh.
Thanks.
It's the news right now, I guess. And I guess you guys are just waiting.
So Richard, thank you for finding some pre-record dates. I'm trying to juggle, you know, when I can get to see my mom, who's in New York at a nursing home. They're, you know, threatening to lock it down. And,
oh dear.
You know, she hasn't seen anybody in weeks.
Mm. Nobody's. I agree. Okay. Well, we'll keep some slots open there and we'll do what we can. All right, we're about ready to start. Stand by.
Elizabeth Stewart, who welcomes the great artists of our community. What follows is a conversation of an artist's experience about the artist's response to trying times, creativity, reinvention, recovery, and of course, flexibility, which is in fact the narrative of our present time.
One, you're live.
Hello, 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 Santa Barbara. It's your chantress of everything valuable and beautiful, Elizabeth Stewart. And I've got a very interesting lineup today. We're going to talk a little bit about the Goleta Valley Art Association. I had no idea, but it's been going on since 1963. It started out with a few members, 16, as a matter of fact, and it's grown to 200. And they're doing a show, which is, you know, a reflection of our problems with Delta virus at La Cumbre Plaza, but it's actually outdoors. And so, and it's sort of a really interesting liaison between the Community Arts Association. I have spoken there and I know Mike Cragen, the director there. And, you know, it's a really cool organization that is centered in the old, you know, kind of Macy's area. So it's a retail storefront, but there's a lot of really interesting artists that do a lot of cool things there. So they've associated with the Goleta Valley Arts Association to do this show. By the way, the show, if you want to take out your pencils, the show is on Saturday, August 21st from 11 to 6 at La Cumbra Plaza. And the sponsors are Art Essentials, La Cumbra Plaza itself, La Cumbra Center for the Creative Arts, Limousine Link, Pacific Western Bank, and Santa Barbara Voice Magazine. So a bunch of folks are behind this, this show. And like I said, there's going to be a lot of artists showing. There's going to be 22 local artists. Things are going to be for sale, gang, and you can buy oils, acrylics, watercolors, collage, stained glass, jewelry, and three-dimensional art, sculpture, et cetera, et cetera. And then I'm interested to know the live music part as well. Terry Lynn Sonnette is actually with us today, Terry Martin Sonnette is with us today. She actually got in touch with me a couple of weeks back and she told me about this show, and I thought this is a really cool opportunity to talk with Terry again. I also have Pat Heller and Marie Arnold with me. Marie was the spearhead to actually lay the organizations together to pull this show off. And we've got these three women who are going to talk to us about the association, about the show, et cetera. And I want to introduce Terry, who I've spoken to before. And Terry is such an interesting person. She was born and raised in New York City. She was program director of a citizens affiliation in the basement of a Catholic church in Hell's Kitchen. And this is how she actually started to communicate with folks that were so different from her. Ex-Ziegfeld girls, artists, theaters, and all kinds of creatives. So Terry's, you know, started her career in the creative world and she's never left it since 1986. She moved here to Santa Barbara in 1986. And she's a member of all kinds of arts organizations. She's also an artist. And she tells me that the Goleta Valley Arts Association actually prospered during this time of lockdown, COVID era. And I want to ask her why that happened. Pat Heller is also here. She is a longtime museumophile. And she joined the LA County Museum of Art as a major gift fundraiser in 2001. And she decided in 2004 to leave for Santa Barbara because her dad lived here in the 70s. I knew her as director of development for the Santa Barbara Maritime Museum. And then Cottage Health recruited her in the campaign to rebuild the hospital. She was with Cottage Health till 2020. And now she's painting full time, as well as cooking and gardening, et cetera. Mm-hmm. And so Pat is going to tell us a little bit about the kind of work she's got hanging. And Marie Gionne Arnold is with us. She is a painter. She's painting in acrylics, collage, and mixed media. Mm-hmm. She's a member of the Goleta Valley Arts Association and the Abstract Art Collective and Carpentria Arts Center. And I knew her as a attendee at some of the lectures I did at La Cumbra Center for the Creative Arts. So really interesting lineup. And I want to start with Terry. Terry, you know, what's intrigued me is that you write that the Goleta Valley Arts Association prospered. I mean, what kind of meetings did you guys hold? Were you on Zoom? Because I know you normally get together and do critiques, et cetera. So what was different about this past 19 months?
Well, thanks for having us.
Yeah.
Exciting. Yes, Zoom. God bless Zoom. The board got together and we kept brainstorming about how are we going to do this? And we took a real big step out to virtual shows. Really early on, we decided to do the virtual shows, had a good response. Our webmaster, Paula Gregor Jones, just pulled it all together. We had not done this before. She revamped the website, and we've had three shows since the pandemic started, starting, was it Picasso for Peanuts? Picasso's for Peanuts was the first one. And we've had, this is our third up now, Summer's End. And we've had good sales. In fact, better sales than we've had in the library. We have a wider audience, of course, all around the U.S., all across the, all around the world. In fact, a friend of mine from Japan, I'm sorry, Korea, just got in touch with me yesterday and told me she liked the show. So a lot of creativity. The members met just to catch up with each other to see what's going on. Many of us are in adult ed classes together. So we were just always brainstorming. And then just the collaboration of artists, art associations, I think.
So I have to say, you know, the first show that you guys did virtually, I followed that and I sent the link to my son and daughter-in-law. They were living in Washington, D.C. at the time, and they purchased three pieces. And so I actually, now they've moved to San Diego, and I had the opportunity to see the three pieces that they hung from the Goleta Valley Arts Association in their new house in San Diego. So when you talk about the outreach, you know, the fact that things can be more globally appreciated, I am testimony to that, Terry. So that it's been effective for sure. Marie, take yourself off mute. You're on mute. I want to ask Marie a little bit about the work on the collaboration between the LCCCA, which is the Coomber Center for the Creative Arts, and the Goleta Valley Arts Association. Is there much crossover in artists?
Well, I'm one of the artists who's a member of both. I've been a member of GVA for at least 10 years, and we started the center 2 years ago. And with Terry, I was on the board for the GVA for many years, and I helped organize their annual show, which used to be at the Stowe House. And so when Terry contacted me this year about having it on the La Combre Mall, I was quite excited about it, because between the 21 artists of GVAA and the 24 artists of La Combre Center, it would give 45 artists all in one place. So I was a great advocate to our center to be a sponsor for the GVAA and to promote one another. So as you know, Mike Cragen is the one who started our center, and I was one of the lucky person who was right there at the beginning. And I'm in the fine line, and we now have 8 artists in the fine line and 8 artists in the other two galleries. So when I start talking to Terry about the show, we thought that would be a great way to promote each other. The main goal of the La Combre Center is to promote arts in the community, and not just painting, but sculpture and dancing and music. Right now we're limited because of COVID, but that's one of the main goal of our center, is to promote the arts in the greater Santa Barbara area. So I just thought this is the perfect opportunity to be in collaboration with them. I believe in the center, we have at least one other person, Judith Villa, who is also a member of GVAA. The other artists are also part of other organizations. So it's a great way to create relationship with all of the artists in this area. And I'm very happy that we're able to do that together.
So Richard's giving us a sign we have to go to quick break, but I want, during the break, I want all three of you to think of a work that you really admire that's in the show. Not, maybe not by yourself, but some other artists, and why, and so, sort of describe it to us, because, you know, obviously this is radio, and I want to hear what you love about a certain piece that's going to be hanging in the show when we get back from the break. Hey, Richard, let's go to quick break.
Yes.
Terry actually picked the songs that are we're going to use to go in and out. So thanks to Terry for that. And we'll be back in a minute with Terry Senate, Marie Arnold, and Pat Heller, Goleta Valley Arts Association, in conjunction with the La Cumbre Center for the Creative Arts. Their show coming up Saturday, August 21st. Outdoors. Don't turn that down.
All right, you're clear.
Come on home.
We're not sure who'll be hanging what, but I guess we can go back to the online show and choose a painting.
I like to talk about the poster.
Our new cool.
Yeah, Princess Feast.
A brand new member.
Francis?
No, Dawn King.
Oh, I thought the art piece on the poster was Frances O'Reilly.
Florence Russell's?
No. The Crow.
Frances Riley.
Yes.
That's great. Pat, what do you want to talk about?
I just looked at the virtual show, and we'll have to just explain that we don't really know what's going to be in the show at La Cumbre. So I picked one from the virtual show to talk about.
Oh, I think I'll do I don't know, our new poster, our new garden, and thank you. And just the creativity of new members and excitement about people.
Okay. You know what I will do? I will talk about working with the people at La Cumbre.
Okay.
Yeah. And thank them.
Yeah. They were just playing a bit from Summer's End music to usher us in and out.
Welcome back. It's Elizabeth Stewart, and I'm speaking with members of the Goleta Valley Arts Association. Terry Martin Sanate brought to my attention that a wonderful show was going to happen at La Cumbre Center for the Creative Arts, and we're going to see the work of 22 artists. There's going to be a lot of interesting folks and live music. It's going to be outside, you know, in the Macy's area there. There's a retail shop that for 2 years Mike Krieger has kind of pulled together a lot of creatives, and it's a hub of activity over there, and some wonderful works to be purchased. And I'm speaking with three artists that are members of the Goleta Valley Arts Association, but they're also liaising with the La Cumbre Center for the Creative Arts. And I asked before the break if the three artists would tell me about a work that will be hanging that they particularly admire. So, like, maybe Pat, we haven't heard from you yet. Start us off.
Well, Elizabeth, thanks again for having us. We really appreciate this. And this is not a juried show, so we're going to be just as surprised as everybody who visits tomorrow as to what's actually hanging in the show. We don't know yet. And we just know who the artists are. But I want to take a moment here to thank the to Mike Cregan, for one, and Marie Arnold for putting us together with Mike. And Mike putting us together with Nicole Silva. She's the leasing agent at La Cumbre Plaza, and I've been working closely with her to make this all come together. And she's just been terrific. So thanks, Nicole. Thanks, Mike, for all your help.
Terry, what work do you admire? What artists that do you admire that will be hanging?
That's, again, hard to say. I'm not sure what people will be choosing. A little diversion here. When I said we thrived during the pandemic, it was time to look at things we'd been doing the same way all the time. So we had a kind of tired logo, symbol,
marketing stuff.
Anyway, so we had a brand new member, John King. She was just selected to join the organization, and she does some graphics work. She's one of those Renaissance women, like many of us are, right? And so she redesigned our logo and our piece that we hang in the library and that will be on all of our works. And it was so great to have a brand new member jumping in and say, what can I do? How can I help? And that's been, we've had several new members like that. So somehow there's an excitement about getting back into art, showing your art, volunteering. And I think that's what makes our organization just a real delightful group to be with. Enthusiasm, knowing that there's something new, different, we can present the community. And our mission is to bring art to the community, as well as the LCCA's mission. They're a standing presence in La Cumbre Mall, but we go about it in different ways. We show our work at the library when the library is open. I think that'll be in December. And bringing art to the Goleta Union after school program. Our volunteers go there and work with the kids. And again, we all participate in many associations, but we're thinking a lot about this bringing art to the community and how that will be, how we'll manifest that in the future.
So tell me a little bit about this, the outreach that you do for the kids.
Marie, have you volunteered in that program?
No, but I was one of the people with, it was Ann Anderson, I think, at the dinner, that we met with the school district, and we had decided to put our money where we really thought it would help the community. So I didn't participate per se, but I think I was one of the person who generated that idea.
And so you go and you bring art after school to the Goleta children?
Yeah, actually, what we used to give money to another organization in town, but we didn't feel that we had a personal relationship with that group. So we thought, we are in Goleta. We want to promote Goleta. So we are now giving, well, I don't know if it's still $1,500 or $2,000 a year, $2,000 a year to the person who offers art for the children in the Goleta Union School who are not able to participate in the PTA program because that costs money. So we give the money, no strings attached, and we tell them, get the supplies, get what you really need. And then a lot of our members go and work with the children using that supply. It's a wonderful way to relate to the kids, also to the parents. And they are so appreciative of what we are doing. And that gives us a sense of being part of Goleta. And because a lot of thing in this area is all about Santa Barbara, which is fantastic, but Goleta also exists as a community, and we really want to touch them. And I think that's probably one of the greatest community project we are doing.
I love it. I love it. Pat, what are you working on right now in your art life?
Oh, well, I retired in January of 2020, and on a Friday, and the following Monday, I started classes with Ruth Ellen Hoag, a local artist.
Yeah.
And so I've been working with acrylics and watercolors for the last year and a half on a regular basis for the first time ever. And so I've been putting together my pieces for the show, and looking forward to having, I do collage as well. And so it'll be fun to be able to get all of us out there. There'll be well over 100 pieces of art for sale among the 21 of us. There were originally 22, now we're down to 21. So we really hope everyone will come and take a look, because part of what we do is the after school program, and part of these sales will go to the Goleta Art Association to help fund that.
I'm interested to know, in your bio, you actually designed hand-painted glassware from 1993 to 2000. And you painted 20,000 pieces with Disney World as your biggest client.
Yes.
So you've been in the art world.
I have.
Yeah. Tell me about that. What was that about?
That was a complete download from somewhere, because I had moved to Atlanta, and a friend of mine there had designed some dinnerware that she was taking to the New York gift show. And she asked me to help her figure out how to display it. And out of nowhere, I said, well, just let me go buy some glasses and I'll paint them to match your dishes. And at that time, I had never done anything like that. And that's how I got started. It was a complete out of nowhere. It became a business it started without me. I had to get a business license and a wholesale license and all. I did a number of gift shows, and Disney World actually held a gift show for people to show their wares. And then they hired me, and I did pieces for four of their resorts based on their logos. I designed glassware based on their logos that they sold in the gift shops.
And do you have any of those?
I do.
Uh-huh.
Saved a few.
and are they collectible at this time?
You know, I don't know. I do know that I also designed glassware for Stolichnaya vodka and, one of the gin companies. They used to do packages at holiday time, a big package with a big bottle of the alcohol and a designer glass in the package. And I've done two of those as well. Those are collectible. I've seen them on eBay.
That's amazing. Amazing. So, yeah. So I just wanted to point out that although you were director of development for a number of organizations, you also were active artists, you know, throughout your life. And so this, when you say you retired and started painting full time, you've actually been in the art world for a long time. Yeah.
But I've just started painting on paper and canvas on a regular basis last year, and I've been really enjoying that. And then the paint company that supplied the glass paint discontinued it. And I've just recently found a new paint that is for glass, and I'm probably going to start painting glass again as well.
I think that would be fantastic. I look forward to that. Richard's giving us a sign we got to go to quick break. I'm just reintroducing. I'm talking with three members of the Goleta Valley Art Association. It's a wonderful organization. I when you guys showed at the library, I used to go every year and bought some things along the line. And you know, they're having a show at La Cumbre Plaza. If you haven't been, there's a storefront that's populated by 20 plus artists. The Goleta Valley Arts Association will be joining with the La Cumbre Center for the Creative Arts. And that's in that Macy's Plaza. And the show is going to be August 21st from 11 to 6. It'll be outside, nice and safe. And there'll be live music. And you'll get to meet the artists as well. They're a great bunch. And I have with us Patricia Heller, I have Terry Martin Sanitai, and I also have Marie Arnold. That's, we're all speaking about this association and all the things that Goleta Valley Arts Association does for the Goleta community. I didn't know about the after school program for kids. And I didn't know Pat Heller was a famous glassware artist either. Fantastic. All right, Richard, we'll go to a quick break and we get back from the break. I want to know what Marie's been up to during the pandemic and how she's been creating. I mean, this is radio, so you can't see, but I think that's a piece of your work behind you, Marie, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
It's one of the pieces I did during the quarantine, actually.
Okay, well, I want to talk about that because it looks like beautiful birch trees from where I'm sitting. Yeah, yeah. Don't turn that tail. Back with these three lovely artists in the Goleta Valley Arts Association in a few minutes.
All right, you're clear.
Okay, Marie. Very good. She's mispronouncing Sanitate, isn't she?
I know.
I don't know.
Yes. Elizabeth, it's Terry.
Yeah.
It's Sanitate.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Or Sanitate if you want to be Italian.
Okay. Thank you.
Here's a couple of the pieces I did for Disney. I don't know if you can see them.
Oh, yeah.
This was for the Contemporary Resort. So I took the Mickey Mouse ears and just made them kind of abstract. Actually, you can see me better than that. And this is for the Yacht Club.
Wow. Gorgeous.
You see, there's little Mickey Mouses in there.
Great, Pat.
The other one I couldn't remember was for Bombay Sapphire Gin. And yeah, so I did two of those. That was fun.
It'd be really interesting if you did like a custom glasses, like for events, because I think people are going to be just anxious to get back to having big parties and events, you know,
yes,
and weddings. Actually,
I have them on my sister-in-law is has Backdrop Boutique, and she's doing a lot of events and making a few patterns of my glassware available for weddings, especially.
You know, it's really interesting. I was writing an article about what we can expect to see in the art world as we kind of crank towards opening our lives up. And I've found that Sotheby's, I trained at Christie's, but anyway, Sotheby's was doing a similar article and they predicted this really interesting thing. They said that local is the new global.
Ah.
And we'll be going forward.
Summer's ends around the bend just flat. The swimming suits are on the line just drag.
In 3, 2, 1, you're live.
Welcome back. It's Elizabeth Stewart, and I'm speaking with three members of the Goleta Valley Arts Association, and I had no idea that the Goleta Valley Arts Association was as old as it is. It's been going on since 1963. It started with a handful of artists. Now they're up to 200. Terry is telling me, Terry Martin Sanitate is telling me that during the pandemic, they were stronger than ever. And I was saying to Terry that I am testimony to that because I looked at all the shows and sent links to friends and family. And my son and daughter-in-law ended up purchasing 3 works from the first show. And so are you going to have an online presence, Terry, for the outdoor show and sale coming up?
That show will not be online. We currently have a show called Summer's End, which I guess we have over 20 artists, and that is currently online. We plan to, I'm pretty sure we will put Picasso's for Peanuts online as well as have a show in the library if we're allowed to go back into the library. So I would say we'll definitely have one more show online. And I think it's a great idea because we reach so many people.
Yeah.
I hope we continue to do that. And working with our webmaster, we work her so hard. I mean, that woman is just, we're so grateful because that's our link to the community. That's what we have right now. So yes, I hope we continue to have an online presence.
So, you know, I was saying that you guys are proponents of local art and local artists. All of you are in at least two or three or more organizations that support local artists. And I was writing an article about the future of the look of the art market and the look of the art event in the future, and came across an article by Sotheby's Auctions out of New York, where they are predicting that local is the new global when it comes to fine art and shows. And they're also predicting that a show like you're doing on August 21st, that is going to be, and the show is actually kind of a poster child for what Sotheby's is saying, that because we are starved for the social element of art, and so seeing art with our friends, seeing art with a drink in our hand, being able to participate in the social part, the social ritual of looking at a show, that will be very treasured for us because we've been away from that for a long time. So that social angle of looking at art together becomes a performance piece in itself. And what they were saying is that the idea of having music and digital screens and the whole of the event being a creative endeavor, not just, you know, the work on a white wall, but the fact that you guys are bringing to the August 21st show music and, you know, a community gathering of two community organizations is actually, you know, kind of a poster child for what the experts in the art market are saying, that the sales are not going to be quite the same because people have rediscovered the beauty of their regional areas. And what they're seeing at auction right now and in sales halls are people aren't really buying the more, I don't know, outside of their region. They're buying within their region, which is a really interesting flip, because my clients, you know, I'm an appraiser, and my clients used to go to LA, San Francisco, purchase there. But now people, because of the pandemic, have been looking at their own communities, and they've been focusing on purchasing works in their own community that have something to do with their own community. So it's a real interesting turnaround. And so when Terry told me about the show, I was thinking, you know, this is a good example of a new way of celebrating being a local artist, instead of the fact that, okay, well, you know, you're a painter from Goleta. I'd rather buy a painter that's from, I don't know, New York. That's not working anymore for people. They're actually starting to buy locally. And I'm really pleased about that, because I think we've got such incredible artists in our area. Marie, you're shaking your head. Yes.
Well, the reason I'm shaking my head is because as you're speaking, I am thinking of two things: who I am looking forward to see again, whose art I'm looking to see. One is Francis Riley, who did the poster for the GVAA. But there are fantastic artists in our community that are known not only in Goleta, but in Santa Ynez, in Ventura, in the greater Santa Barbara, in Los Angeles. We have, for example, Carol Dixon, who makes fantastic little collages that are easily sellable. We have people like Elizabeth Flanagan and Janet Hart, Rosalie Beer. If you have the opportunity to own one of Rosalie's pieces, You are one of the lucky people in this community. But what is so important is that there is no longer this idea that you must be a millionaire to own fine art. Fine art is right here. And the reason the prices are reasonable is because we don't have a gallery in New York and we're in this expensive area. But you could get fantastic quality fine art right here at the La Cumbre Center as well as the GVAA. And people could buy very affordable, fantastic little treasure. And I think that's what helps the community to appreciate art and to be able to own some art, some original. Why go to Pier 1 when you could buy the same piece for the same amount, but an original piece?
So, right.
And I know La Cumbre will, the Center for Creative Art, we will participate in the Van Gogh exhibit that's coming up for the museum. And that's another way to promote access to fine art. We also will have, most likely, it's not definitive, but we'll have a program for children to experience what Van Gogh did, how we get there. And so, and the Goleta Valley Art does the same thing. I mean, some of these artists in the Goleta Valley Art Association are well known, well around the country, even outside the country, there are some collectors. So I think that to me is very inspiring.
Oh, that's fantastic. I want to hear more about the Van Gogh connection. What Marie is talking about is, you know, the Santa Barbara Art Museum has been renovated. It's a $50 million renovation. Then that was August 15th, they opened their doors and had an opportunity to be wowed by the architecture and by the new galleries and the all of the work they've been doing around the contemporary art world, mm-hmm. you know, welcoming that into the three new galleries for contemporary art. And they're doing a blockbuster show of Van Gogh and how he lived and painted and more about his person. So that's coming up real soon. And Marie is talking about an affiliation I did not know about that. So maybe we can talk a little bit about that when we get back from the break. Richard's giving us a sign we got to go to quick break. Reintroducing Terry Sanitate, Pat Heller, and Marie Arnold. And the show we're celebrating is the Outdoor Show and Sale, 22 Artists at La Cumbre Plaza of the Goleta Valley Arts Association. Okay, Richard, let's go to quick break. Don't turn that dial. Back in a minute.
Maybe we found
you are clear.
You know, somehow I think, Terry, you've mentioned Picasso's For Peanuts a couple of times. I think we need to explain what that is.
Yeah.
That's some point.
I'm not very articulate this morning. I'm sorry.
You're doing just
all this. It's not our logo. It's our.
I don't know.
Our slogan, anyway.
Sign or so.
Yeah.
I also wanted to mention about the pop-ups that are happening about bringing art to the community. Elizabeth just put some work down in Santa Barbara Visual Artists down at Seo Nuevo yesterday. So we've got pop-ups. And I want to mention that the Faulkner was amazing. I gallery sat and we had over 100 people come through. Never before.
Great. That's another sign of the local interest, I think.
Yeah, so I want to mention that too.
And a lot of people from GVAA also are member of SBAA, mm-hmm. and Abstract Collective and
mm-hmm. Scape.
Exactly.
You know, there's a new down in Ventura, the Buenaventura Art Association has an abstract art collective down there too. That's pretty new. And they do monthly programs. I've hung out with them online. Yeah.
Elizabeth, I think it would be good too at some point before we close to say that we have in normal times, whatever that is, we had monthly shows at the library that were juried. And every month that juror would give a critique at the end of the show, which is, I don't think any other art organization does that. So it's unique, and we want to invite people to consider joining our group.
Okay.
That's the greatest appeal of GVAA, that art critique on a monthly basis is invaluable. It's free, for one thing. And to have expert coming and do a positive critique of your work, and you gather ideas. You have no idea how much we really learn from these critiques. It's really essential.
And it's open to the public.
All the leaves are brown. All the leaves are brown. And the sky is gray. And the sky is gray.
3, 2, 1. You are live.
It's Elizabeth Stewart, and I'm talking today with three members of the Goleta Valley Arts Association, a longtime arts association started in 1963, and a really active and innovative association, 200 members. I've actually spoken at the library to a bunch of the Goleta Valley Arts Association artists, and Pat was saying during the break that one of the unique things about Goleta Valley Arts Association is that they did a monthly critique. So artists could hang their work and an expert would then opine on the, do a critique, and it was free to the members. Marie is telling me that she learned so much. And Marie, did your painting change after a critique?
A lot of time I was inspired by, yes, in many ways it has changed. I mean, as an artist, I believe that you have to explore new ideas and new forms. And a lot of times, yes, attending those critiques, it opened my eyes at looking at different values in my work, different colors. So yes, that was very, very inspirational for me. It's interesting, you were just playing California.
Dreaming, yeah.
And during the COVID, the first thing I did is clean my home studio. So I used to do painting that were like 5x7, 8x10, and then I would go 18x24. Well, I am now doing 36x48, which is huge. And I did a whole, I think there were 9 pieces, 30x40, 36x48, called Abstract California Landscape. And I put it on a video and I used that song as the background. So yes, COVID in many ways inspired us, because we were at, most of us, we were at home, and what do? You know, I have to be active. And it really allowed me a period of, introspection. And then that was manifested in my art. And most of these pieces now are at the La Cumbre Center. I won't be putting them in the GVAA show because I would take all the panels, but I do have them at the La Cumbre Center. So
fantastic. Richard's giving us a sign we got to go to quick break, but Pat, I want to hear what you have to say regards what Marie just expressed, that, you know, the critiques plus the introspection that she had the opportunity to do has changed her work from very small to very large. That's fascinating. You know, the scope has increased. So yeah. Marie's world shrunk and her art got big. I mean, imagine that. When we get back from the break, Pat's going to tell us about what she's been up to as well. Don't turn that down. Hey, Richard, let's go to quick break. I'm speaking with Pat Heller, Terry Sanitate, and Marie Arnold, members of the Goleta Valley Arts Association, because we're celebrating their liaison at the La Cumbre Center for the Creative Arts, where Macy's is outside. They're doing a group show and the show is 22 artists. The work is affordable. It's beautiful. It's multimedia, from jewelry to sculpture to two-dimensional, et cetera. Prints, watercolors, you know, you name it, there it'll be there. The show is August 21st from 11 to 6, and it'll be a cool event. There's going to be live music, and you get to meet the artists and get to socialize around art a little bit in a safe environment outside. So it's custom made for right now. Don't turn that down. I'll be back in a minute.
All right, you're clear.
Marie, I can't wait to meet you. I feel like I know you, but I've never met you. Thank you so much for putting the two associations together for us. It's really made a difference. Thank you.
Oh, good. I'm glad.
Yes, and you hold
the history. I was on the board for about 5 or 6 years, and then I was the treasurer. So I know how much work it requires to put that show.
Oh my goodness. Well, you know, we moved it from Stowe House because they no longer have their big parking lot available. And last year, of course, we didn't have a show. So it's like, well, what are we going to do? And then I thought of the galleries there and thought, wow, wouldn't it be great to have the show at La Cumbra, where there's more traffic, there's restaurants, there's, you know, all of it. So, and much easier physically to set it up.
Yeah, there's parking.
Yes, parking. Parking can make or break an event.
It does. So, yeah. We talk about it. I'm really getting, I'm looking forward to tomorrow and be with other people. It all will go very well. We know it at the end, we always sweat it off. But, you know, no matter, it's not how much money we're going to make. It's how much we could connect with people. Mm-hmm. And people will come back and people will appreciate it. I come out of this show totally exhausted because, as you could tell, I talk a lot. So I talk to everybody who comes by, and I think that what makes a difference. Sharing what I do with other people. To me, I used to say a piece is not complete until someone else looks at it.
I love that.
Either hates it or loves it. It doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. But it creates a connection. And that's what art is about, to me anyway, is that connection that it creates with people. So,
and with each other.
And with each other, absolutely.
Oh yes, we all are. We have a big mutual admiration society going on here. We all admire each other's art.
Yes.
This is not a competition.
When your legs don't work like they used to before. And I can't sweep you off of your feet. Will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your
4
cheek?
Minutes in 3, 2, 1, darling, you're live.
Welcome back. It's Elizabeth. I'm speaking with members of the Goleta Valley Arts Association. Their association is doing a wonderful show Saturday, August 21st from 11 to 6, an outdoor art show and sale. So, Pat, you wanted to say something before we went to quick break.
Yes, I was going to say, as a purchaser of art over many decades, it always meant more to me if I could meet the artist. And I think that's one of the attractions of the local art boom, if you will, is that people can actually meet the person who painted the picture or made the sculpture or whatever it is. But I also wanted to say that because of the lockdown last year and some of the things going on in the world, I actually painted for the first time something that was in response to an event. And it's unlike anything I've ever done. It was in response to the murder of George Floyd. Mm-hmm. And I did two of them, and it was a new experience for me to paint in reaction to something like that. And that just wouldn't have happened, I don't think, without being confined and being bombarded with this constant news of all the things that were going on at the time. So I just wanted to throw that out there. That's one thing it has done for me. It has, that introspection was very important in that work.
So Richard and I have been doing this show since March of last year. Then we've had some amazing artists on the show. And one of the, my favorite sound bites, I guess you could say, is we had an artist who was talking about the multiple pandemics, you know, happening at once, you know, the social, the biological, et cetera. And he said, you know, we're actually feeling it because we're artists, we feel it. And I wish that people would look more closely at our work right now, because what is the artist's role in society? And he answered his own question. He said, we are the problem solvers. By the nature of what we do, we solve problems. When we approach a canvas, that's a problem to be solved. So it's in our DNA that we are looking for answers and we're solving problems in our work. And so I think what you're saying, Pat, about, you know, all of a sudden you were reacting to something. Go ahead.
I want to add that I talked with someone, another painter who was a school teacher, and she said how upset she was when the arts were taken out of the schools because art teaches problem solving.
Yeah.
And I had never heard that before, and it just reflects on what you just said.
That's very true. Well, we have to say goodbye. And Terry, thank you so much for bringing this show to my attention and introducing me to Marie and Pat again. And lovely to see you all and have fun at the show. Marie was getting all verklempt. She was saying, oh my God, these shows are so, you know, they're so energy sucking, but I just love it. And I can just see yeah. why. So good luck on the show. I hope that you reach a lot of people. I hope that a lot of folks can enjoy the work there. And by the way, you know, just very quickly, the show online, my son bought some work, but he also commissioned the artist after he purchased. So that's something that was, yeah, really cool. Anyway, good luck on the show.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, you're clear. Made it just in time. Thank you so much.
So I'm going to send all of you the clip to the show.